It's about noon now. We've been waiting on these contracts for a week. The whole idea is to package these things together so we can offload them. And we still don't have a phone call with contracts, so the clock is ticking.
This is the do or die day.
Hey guys, it's Tuesday. It's the first day back in the office after a long 4th of July. It's a hectic day. We have a meeting with the staff that's gonna last about an hour and a half, and then we have a bunch of deals that were falling through the cracks on our days off. We gotta try to get those over the finish lines, and then unexpectedly, we have like two lawsuits that we're in the middle of that we have to handle too. So it's gonna be crazy hectic today, guys, but if your day is not hectic, you're probably not flipping enough houses.
All right, cool. So I was going to do a June recap since July has been, you know, so slow. We were off last week. So I'll go over the numbers for June. We had 9 buys last month, so that's awesome. Also a solid month.
Yeah. Nice job, guys.
Yeah. What's up, boys?
Frankie Deals.
Nice to see you.
Hey.
Where's your corn on?
That's what I give to you.
Yeah, so I haven't seen Larry. I haven't seen him about 7 days. Every day he's telling me about this exciting present that he got me, thinking it's going to be, you know, he scored a big deal without us. That have happened sometimes. And it turned out to be corn.
Do you handpick it for me?
Yeah.
You guys want a piece of corn?
Yeah, I just wanted to give you an update. We sent out the contracts about a couple hours ago. What's the time on, like, will we see him early this afternoon?
I can explain this is what's going on with this deal. It's one piece of property that is divided into two subdivisions. So essentially it's a private driveway on this particular property in Connecticut, and it houses two separate parcels of land. So we had to go in front of the zoning committee. This is a 6-month deal in the works. We put it out there to an investor that we know, and he decided that he was gonna move forward on the project. We've been back and forth. We are literally losing time and we're losing money if this deal does not get put together. We're expecting a call back by 1 o'clock. Chris is gonna get an update. If the update is anything other than the fact that the contract's been signed and the deposit has been submitted, the deal's off, and then we're gonna list these properties on the MLS for each for about $50,000 higher than what we would be in contract for with the person that's gonna buy it. Frank's about to make a phone call, a tough call, about a situation we had in Washington, Connecticut.
One of the sellers tried to, he was very fraudulent in the transaction, tried selling us a piece of property with contaminated soil.
So we opted to back away from the deal. We felt we had the ability to do so, given the way the contract was written and the fact that they didn't properly disclose.
Our attorney actually didn't see that there was specific performance in the contract, which means that if we backed out of the contract, we're forced to purchase the home. So we're gonna talk to our attorney and figure out who's gonna pay the $10,000 bill. That'll be an interesting conversation. Here we go.
Hey, Frank.
We would never sign a contract with specific performance. And we felt that was, you know, missed.
So the bottom line and what we learned throughout this situation is we really have to do our own due diligence. We can't rely on others. We really just have to, even if you have professionals involved, you have to just double check the work, because at the end of the day, it stops with you.
It's about noon now, and we still don't have a phone call with contracts, so the clock is ticking.
Listen, your boy Jeff, in all certainty, this is not for the camera. In 20 minutes, he's either saying the contract is signed or we're listing it.
Me and Larry are about to make another unpleasant call. And it's to another investor out in Long Island who about 4 months ago, we realized he was using the Dealhouse name. We spoke to this gentleman last week, and he's actually a very nice, reasonable guy. He claims he had the Dealhouse logo before us, which I don't think is true. And we basically left off that, let's come up with a solution and try to figure this out, you know, outside the legal landscape.
Hi.
Hey, what's up? My concern is, you know, I know you have the, you spent money on the domain. We have this Dealhouse meetup where we're, you know, raising a lot of money through the meetup. We're started a company called Dealhouse Capital Lending. That site's coming out.
I just think there's definitely going to be confusion because we're in very similar spaces.
What if you did this, and I'm just talking out loud, Chris. I mean, I know you mentioned, and I respect, you know, you said you spent $100,000 on technology and stuff. But in terms of the branding, I mean, you really haven't put anything, you know, out there.
No, that's not true. I haven't officially launched the whole concept yet. So you guys don't see any of that. But I have $50,000 in commercials made.
We have Dealhouse NY. We have Dealhouse LI. We have Dealhouse Lending. We have, like, we have Dealhouse everything.
But if you guys don't think we can exist in the same space, I'm not going to walk away from what I did. We're going to have to, unfortunately, fight it out with the attorneys.
We want to stay friendly. We want to continue to do business. So we'll see how it ends. At the end of the day, it's our responsibility, everything that happens here.
We'll get back to you. Thanks, Chris.
You got it, guys. Take
all right. Take care. None of this has to do with paint color, furniture, staging. It's the real stuff that goes on to make these deals happen. Really, this is the business. So today was a busy day. Besides dealing with all the properties that we're in the process of acquiring, as well as renovating, we also were dealing with two legal situations. One of them is resolved, and the other one, hopefully we will have a resolution. Frank and I are gonna do some more talking, and you know, we're dealing with a relatively reasonable person, so we're hoping that next time we speak, we'll have some good updates for you. Frank, what time is it?
Dude, it's late and I'm tired.
You know how I get when I don't eat, right?
Let's go eat.
All right, let's go.
I'm dying.
How about a corn salad?
Huh?
Corn salad?
Corn salad. I threw the corn out the window.
Yeah, that was nice of you. You guys have been watching Dealhouse Presents. Subscribe here for more.